So welcome back. Now in this video, we are going to discuss about the three-chambered and four-chambered heart that is being seen in, as I already told you, that reptiles and amphibians show three-chambered heart and crocodile, birds and mammals show four-chambered heart. So what kind of circulation is there in these hearts? Let's see that. So children, I must tell you that circulation patterns are of three types. Single circulation, which you have done in the fishes in the previous video. I had also shown you how this circulation takes place. Now we are going to do incomplete double circulation and double circulation now in this video. So incomplete double circulation means double circulation, but it is not a complete one. And the double circulation, which is represented by our heart, human heart, plus birds and crocodile. So let's see, single circulation we have already done. So now we are going to do this incomplete double circulation, children. Now you see this, it shows that it is seen in amphibians and few reptiles like crocodile. Left atrium, now children, this is the left atrium, the red portion. This is the heart. This is your heart, not your heart, rather the heart of a reptile or an amphibian. So this is the red portion is the left atrium. This one is the right atrium. And this is only one ventricle. No left and right, but only one ventricle. So now, what they write here is, left atrium will receive, you see the arrow, downward arrow. Left atrium is receiving the oxygenated blood. That is why it has been given red color, to just to show that it is oxygenated blood. Okay, from now, where is this oxygenated blood coming from? After purification, it is coming after purification. So it is coming from either gills or lungs or skin. That depends which one is the respiratory organ. So that oxygenated blood is coming from a respiratory organ and it is moving on to the left atrium. So one circulation is this. Now you see, right atrium gets, now right atrium is also getting blood, see, at the same time. Left atrium is getting blood from the gills or lungs or the skin, and similarly right atrium, you see, is getting blood which is deoxygenated. Now from where will the deoxygenated blood come? From all the body parts, because the body parts have used up the oxygen and given out the carbon dioxide. So the deoxygenated blood is collected from various body parts and then it is being given to the right atrium. So both right and left atrium are filled at a time, you see. Okay, now however they get mixed up. Now here though the blood is not getting mixed up. The deoxygenated and oxygenated blood is not getting mixed up. But when these both the bloods move into the ventricle, of course, they will get mixed up because it is only one chamber, that is ventricle. So you see, they have represented or they have given a different color to the blood which is in ventricle now, because of course, the shade will get differ. Because when oxygenated and deoxygenated blood will mix, so the shade of the blood will not be either blue nor red. So they have given a different color here. So they get mixed up in the single ventricle. Now ventricle then pumps this mixed blood. Ventricle, you see, from ventricle, you see the arrow, the blood moves on again to the gills or the lungs or the skin, whatever. Now there this blood goes and it gets purified. And whichever the deoxygenated blood will get purified, and then again they will be pumped out to the left atrium after oxygenation. So you see, this is incomplete double circulation. Yes, double circulation is there because to, simultaneously the two chambers are getting filled up, but it's not complete because the ventricle is only one here. So this is an example of incomplete double circulation. All right. And the fully double circulation or complete double circulation heart represents in this manner, which we will be doing when we will be discussing human heart also. But a very brief account I am giving here. Birds and mammals. right atrium receives, you see, right atrium, this is blue portion is the right atrium, the upper chamber, it will receive the deoxygenated blood. See, it is receiving, see the arrow, it is getting, it is receiving deoxygenated blood. Okay, it passes, now this deoxygenated blood passes from right atrium to right ventricle, this is right ventricle. Okay, and left atrium is filled up with oxygenated blood, this is left atrium filled with oxygenated blood, and from there it is passed on to left ventricle here. Okay, ventricle then pumps out this blood, see, to various parts of the body. Okay, without any mixing, there is no mixing of blood in the auricles or in the ventricles, no mixing of blood anywhere in the heart. So this is complete double circulation.